Got to work. Shit! Okay, come on. Get you back to the doctor. Get in.
Yep.
Thank you.
Giddy up. Every time. Yep. If the doctor asks, there was one horse when I found you. You okay? Here.
you know this Shredder, don't you?
Is that? Oh, my.
Look who it is. I did not count on seeing that wagon again. Nor you, for that matter.
Only people you won't be seeing are the folks who took it.
I take it they aren't the only ignorant bullying clodhoppers in these parts. But I can live in glorious hope. Now, it wasn't a trouble now, was it?
No, it was a pleasure.
Well, let me give you something for your pleasure. What we got here. How about this? Provide a man a tincture, he'll be well for a day. Teaching to make one, he might be well a while longer.
I'll make sure to try and make this. Thank you.
Thank you. It won't work for anything chronic, but you may not need it to. Well, if you see me on my travels and you're in need of something, Make sure you come and say hello.
Travel safe now. Hey, boy. Hey, boy. You, mister, excuse me.
Hello.
What can I do for you? Let's do it.
Hi, folks.
How do you do, sir?
Why, hello there, sir.
Hello, mister.
Hello. Please come in.
Mister?
I like you, mister. You have a kind face.
Hmm.
Well, good luck to you.
See ya.
Mister?
Mister?
You're doing a great job.
Hey to you, old Mr. Gray. You are your damn pathetic bastard sons. Yeah, because y'all boys prove yourself to be young. Yeah, you're bullies, not fighters. That's true.
Partner?
Hey, mister. Will you give me some money?
You know Tina's sister, Jane? She spit at a John and he choked her to death right there. Sweet bitch, too dumb for her own good.
Sure.
Damn nation.
Well, thank you.
Say, where you from?
Around.
Ain't from right here. If that was you, I'd leave. This town lost its goddamn soul a long time ago. Nothing but nasty, miserable people.
Yeah?
Yeah, ever since them Grays moved here. A bunch of no-good white trash. Yeah, they somehow got rich. About 50 years ago, they moved here, caused a whole heap of trouble. Yeah, I reckon they was Yankee spies during the war and everything.
That's so.
Yeah, sure.
Mister,
you gotta take a break every now and then.
Worry about your own work and listen.
Ah, you're back. Have a look. All for sale, except the floor.
Hello, mister.
If you fancy doing some shopping, come on back.
I put my savings into booze again. What an idiot.
You can't assign my sample.
But you won't.
You okay?
Do I look okay?
No. You look awful.
Awful. Look at me. Useless.
I wasn't born to this. I didn't deserve this. I used to be a gentleman.
Jeremiah Compson. Compson's dead.
Good for you. If that's anything to boast about.
They took everything from me.
Who did?
They.
And what did they take?
My whole life.
Oh. Excuse me, partner.
Pard?
How's things?
You see me smiling?
Excuse me, madam, behind you.
Hey!
You know, there's something about this place.
Was that right?
Anyway, can't put my finger on it.
See you around.
Mister?
Partner?
Just admiring your horse there.
Thank you.
Move!
Anyway, just passing the time of day.
Take care of yourself.
Partner.
Hello.
You know a good place? Get some food?
Don't know, sorry.
I was just asking.
So long. Well, that's just fine then.
Welcome back.
Don't believe it, but I just heard that the doctor's been ordering surplus ointments for his own...
Okay, safe travels.
Hey.
How do you do?
Here's some drunk, uppity stranger got curled up last night.
That's just how it is.
Hello, sirs.
Hello.
How do you do?
Hey, watch it.
Hello, sir.
Hello.
Mister?
How you do?
The queasy feeling you've been
having?
Look out! Because there's so many O'Driscolls about.
I think you think I wanted that snake to bite. I think it's awful convenient.
You ass!
You ain't scaring nobody.
Whoa!
Watch yourself.
What's that about?
Come here.
Hello there.
Hello again. I got some good... bred horses. Sure there's one to your liking. Best to have a good saddle that'll hold up. Adding on to a saddle helps personalize it. That's a nice addition on a saddle. Adding on to a saddle helps personalize it. Always good to have one of those. Good saddles is almost as important as a good horse. Nice! You only live once, lest you're a cat.
Bring that horse back if you need anything.
How are you doing?
Getting quick, folks, before I eat all these chops myself.
it in. Faster. Go. Mister?
Ain't in.
Hey, move it!
What do you think
you're
doing?
Calm down, will you? Okay, settle down there. Yeah.
You! Stay right there and don't move!
You got a bullet coming, you don't stop still.
This here's a holdup. You know what to do.
Why don't you stretch your legs, huh?
Okay.
Last warning.
Okay.
All right, you son of a bitch, hands up. This is a robbery.
Bye-bye.
Get closer.
Any request?
Okay there. Idiot.
Okay, Sheriff. Here they are.
Tell the Marshal this ain't how we do things here. But I'll oblige him this once. All right. Let's see what we got. Well, let's get you in there, then. I'm gonna need your details. You aren't going anywhere, and neither am I. Take the time and get this right. From what I hear, you ain't leaving us anytime soon. We're gonna need a fair record of you. Tell me everything except that you're innocent. I'd find that hard to believe. Quite a record we'll have on you. You're lucky you were caught, you know. The way the town feels about what happened, you were likely to be shot. It's a process, all right, but a necessary one. How you doing with that? Okay, then. Yep. and get your picture took. Bring your hands up onto your chest. Hold it. Jackson! Officer Jackson, move those prisoners! Officer Benton! Kitchen's East staff! Officer Townsend, those rocks ain't gonna break themselves! What are you standing there for? Get moving! What are you looking at? Go on! Get moving!
You! You! You with the hammer! And you'll do. We need to perform a work detail out in Rhodes. Come on, get in. Open the gate. Come on, Milliken. Tell you what, old Jameson is a wretched, sour old bastard, and no mistake. You lot stay calm in there.
You weren't saying nothing.
Well, you are now. Shut up. You know, my wife has acquired ideas significantly above her station. She's been reading too many goddamn books. Personally, I'm against education. Of women, I mean. And men, I guess. Unnecessary. Doesn't add much to the world. Education.
Good day, gentlemen.
Oh.
Don't do anything stupid. Nobody gets shot. Act like fools, and the pair of you will be dead within a minute. Now, what are your names?
Jenkins and Milliken.
Well, Mr. Jenkins and Mr. Milliken. Throw your guns to the ground and get on down here. That's it. Very glad to meet you. It's not worth being rash. You boys get paid a salary. You get that salary whether these people escape or not. Your wives presumably want you alive. Let them out. Now, please.
Okay. Okay.
You all run away. Aside from you. Try to stay out of trouble. This is a stroke of good fortune for all of you. Use it. Now, Mr. Jenkins and Mr. Milliken, be so kind as to quickly run away before somebody gets shot entirely unnecessarily. Go on, don't look back. Mr. Wendt, I believe it was $50 we agreed on.
It was.
Here's 50 each.
Each?
Yes. Now get out of here, both of you. My employer and I appreciate your professionalism.
All we did was stand there and look tough.
And you did it fantastically well. Good day, gentlemen. Now, ma'am, how about you pick up these guns and we move out? My mistress is waiting for us. Come along. Then you better get on this horse. It's not much of an animal, but they haven't got far to ride. Just get on the horse when you're good and ready, okay? There'll be plenty of time for adventures. Now, if you follow me, please. Ready? Wonderful. I hope you'll forgive the secrecy. My employer particularly values discretion. My name is Mr. Horley, by the way. 6 months at Sisica Penitentiary. Awaiting a hanging for a murder you did not commit must have felt a whole lot longer, my friend. You still seem strong, though. I mean, doesn't look like breaking all those rocks has left you entirely broken, in body or in spirit. I hope I am right about that. Rounding you folks up, and those sham trials, they were a disgrace. Made a mockery of the rule of law. Still can't quite believe they got away with it. There's others convicted when you were. Came out breathing fire. Maybe you're like that too. Guess we'll see. You're just up here. There's the camp. Hit your horse. Come on, hitch up. This way. She's anxious to meet you.
Madam, we're back.
Hello. Jessica, the clerk, how do you do? What did you tell her?
Nothing, as we discussed.
Thank you, Hawley. I do hope we haven't inconvenienced you dreadfully. But seeing as you were due to be hanged in a week, I'm sure you don't object too strongly. I know you're innocent. Well, not perhaps exactly innocent, but not guilty of what you were accused. I know you and those who were with you that died were little more than patsies, and that you were set up by one of three men or a woman, possibly by all of them. I can't be sure, but that is all I know so far.
And one of these people also made Mrs. Leclerc a widow.
And I will avenge my husband's death, so help me God. But I will not avenge it upon them who did not cause it, or caused it unwittingly. Anyway, I'm sure this is all a touch confusing and melodramatic. Where are my manners? Hawley, please show our guests to their tent and give them some fresh clothes to put on.
Very good, madam.
Then serve us both a little refreshment.
Certainly, madam. This way. You'll find a change of clothes in there, alongside a few other items you might need, a lasso, a knife, and a lantern, I believe.
That looks more comfortable. Hawley?
Here, madam.
Your very good health. I suppose it beats dying,
Mrs. Leclerc's husband was murdered by one of his business partners.
And I intend to find out which one. Or rather, I intend for you to find out. And kill them. You're the only person I could possibly trust to do whatever it takes. Because you and your accomplices, you're the only other victims of their lies still alive. See, you walked into the town at approximately the same time my husband was shot in the back, but by another gun, firing different bullets to those you possessed when you were arrested. These bullets. This was their mistake. You were rounded up and sentenced to death, all because you came to town and didn't talk too much and seemed like you were nasty. Anyway, here they are. the people who run Blackwater. Mr. Jeremiah Shaw, banker, real estate speculator, and crook. Mr. Amos Lansing, ranch owner, speculator, and crook. Mrs. Grace Lansing, his wife, society patroness, lover of the arts. Crook, my former best friend. Teddy Brown, her disgraced brother, outlaw, wanted man, and still in contact with them. All I ask of you is your help in finding out quite what happened.
Mrs. LeClerc would like to help you get back on your feet. Get back to work.
Whatever your work may be, I don't judge. You want to rob? Rob. You want to save innocent folk? Do that as well. But you need me just as much as I need you. I think we all understand each other.
I hope we do.
Good. I look forward to rewarding you for killing those who made me a widow. My husband was a true believer in this country and in the West. He was killed for greed. Foul greed when there's quite enough for everybody. I don't care what your scruples are as to killing. I will take the full burden of that sin upon my shoulders. Goodbye, for now. Then Hawley, go introduce her to nice Mr. Cripps.
I think you'll like Cripps well enough. He's long past his prime, of course, but he hasn't gone entirely crazy just yet. And he will help you better than most of his ilk. Cripps! Get up!
Hello, partner. Hawley.
This is your new boss.
Oh, pleased to meet you, partner. J.B. Cripps at your service.
We'll pay to get your camp established. Mrs. LeClerc is a generous benefactor.
And where are we headed?
Oh, and madam, while Cripps is establishing your camp, perhaps you can go to the station and see the clerk, then head to see Clay Davies. He's a horse thief and not a terribly nice one. Then meet Cripps back at your camp.
See you shortly, boss.
Good luck.
Caught the help talking about that boy you got killed in Rhodes. Seems to have them all shook
oh,
up.
Oh, gracious.
Hello. You, you must be a Horley's friend. He's one of us. He said you are also a discouraged creature. Now, I will be honest. I try not to talk too much to women. Well, let's leave that. Alden, that's me. But Horley insisted you was okay. I'm very discouraged, you see. Anyway, it's a pleasure to make your acquaintance. Sort of. I find your reticence charming. Real charming. I heard you might want to earn a little extra money. Well, some gentlemen have been robbing our stages, and they are not part of the club, if you catch my meaning. If you can make them go away, I'm sure they will have something of interest to you. They're up at Blue Water Marsh. See what you can do, okay? Here, by the way, a catalog. The latest issue just came into this armpit from a land more civilized. And if things work out, well, my colleagues and I move around these stations as needed. And all of us are very discouraged. We will all help you with pertinent information, even if you are a lady. Good afternoon, ma'am.
Jesus cussing Christ!
Thank you.
I win again. Did Horley send you, Pop? I'm Clay Davies. This is my brother.
Clive.
He don't talk. Maybe you two will get along better. Maybe not. Listen, I heard you wanted to earn some money. So, there's a gang of ne'er-do-wells. They are a bunch of degenerates, not good people. They're out in Rhodes with a bunch of horses they stole off of me. Well, that's a lie, but they stole them off a fella I was gonna steal them off of. Maybe you could get them for me. You think you could do that for me, Pop? Oh, look. Here are your friends. Well, good. Meet me at the stable at Saint Denis once you have the horse flesh, and I'll pay you good. Oh, and Pop, Horley wanted me to remind you any decent work you can find, take it. But just try to stay out of trouble. Oh, and once you give me those horses, well, after that, we'll talk again. Oh, I do so enjoy these conversations. I'm used to them on account of my brother. Let's go, Clive!